In this tutorial, you'll learn how to scalp racks. I will explain all the steps from scratch. Please subscribe and turn your notification on so you don't miss any tutorials. First, we have to create the form and general shape of the stone according to our reference. I did this by scaling with gizmo and trim curve brush because it allows me to create the shape I want very quickly and edit it very easily. To do this, it is better to dynamesh our base so we can easily form and shape it. With the help of gizmo, trim, curve brush, clay tube brush, mask, and move brush, we try to create the general shape of the stone carefully. We can import trim smooth border brushes from ZBrush Lightbox section in the brushes tab in trim folder. This brush can be used in all steps of stone sculpting. With this brush, we can tap or make short movements to catch the sharp edges of the mesh. Or by pulling this brush longer, we can create the stone porosity and bulge. We can also use the Alt key when pulling the brush. When using this brush, be sure to choose the right size for each part, because the size of this brush is important. With the help of the brushes and tools, we continue to scalp our stone to create the main forms and shapes. Remember to always use references. Once we are sure of the shape, form, and silhouette, we move on to the secondary forms. With the help of slash 3 and damp standard brushes, we scalp secondary details of the stone, and then we select the brushes I mentioned before and work on the marked parts to get closer to their friends. Note that the forms you create should have a good variety and be close to the realistic stone. Don't forget that in organic works, the closer the forms are to nature, the work in the end will be more realistic. Controlling the light and shadows created by the bumps and the mesh has a tremendous impact on the result. In each part of the work, you have to choose the mesh resolution according to the amount of detail you are working on. This is done by dynamesh. You should always scalp general shapes with lower resolution and details with higher resolution. For stone sculpting, when dynameshing, it is better to set the blur to 0 to better maintain the mesh. During the sculpting time, you may notice parts of your work that seem wrong and problematic. This is quite normal and will be solved by modification and editing. Do work with patience and motivation during the sculpting time to finish and make your job done. We check the scale and silhouette again to make sure we did everything right. In this step, we will scalp tertiary details with the same brushes and techniques mentioned in the previous step. It is better to increase the mesh resolution. If we add too much resolution, we can't move and we have lag. So choose your resolution carefully. Now we should try to edit and fix any problems that we see in the work, and then we will scalp smaller details. This step may be short or long, depends on the type of stone you choose. As in the previous steps, try to do your work with patience so the work becomes clean and realistic. If you want to add a new part to your stone that does not exist, you can make a base in a separate subtool and then adjust it with the previous mesh and dynamesh it. Then give it details to match with other parts. Finally, we have reached the last step. In this step, we give micro details to the work and we have to use brushes and alpha for details. Using brushes will make your job easier and faster. I created cracks and fractures of the stones with the crack brushes provided by CG Sphere, which helped to make this stone more detailed and realistic. You can also use these brushes for the edges of the stones. These brushes have a great variety and can be used for all types of stones. Textures of the stones are different, so according to the reference and type of stone, scalp the edges of the stone with brushes of the right size. After the cracks and edges, we should give our rock a texture. I use CGSphere 500 Rock Alpha. To do this, first select a brush, for example standard. Open the brushes section again and select the clone option. Then set the stroke to drag rig mode and from the alpha section, select the import option and select alpha. Now we can use alpha by dragging the brush on the mesh. For more control, we can use the mask brush, the intensity and focal shift. We can also manually scale details with clay brushes, but this may take a lot of your time and not end up with the same quality as the alpha. I use CGSphere Rock Bundle. You can download this bundle with link in the description down below. Guys, we love you and we want to create more tutorials. We need your support to continue. So don't forget to subscribe and like this video. See you in the next video.